Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the channel. Now, this is going to be a video that's a little bit different than some of the things that I normally do. I will do my best not to rant this evening, but we're going to talk about, yes, you guessed it, veganism. So I've seen a few things on YouTube about people stating their opinions, some facts, some fiction. A lot of people are angry about the plight of the animals that we use as our food stock, cattle, chickens, whatnot. And I get it. I'm 100% down with not mistreating animals. I'm wholeheartedly for anyone who says that they're not happy with how we treat our livestock, the animals that we use to feed ourselves. No, I don't think that it is moral to eat something that is, I guess, live to sustain ourselves because it tastes good. I get it. I'm 100% down. I've seen recent videos by Cosmic Skeptic and others who have said that, hey, this is just horrible. I agree. You'll get no argument from me on that fact whatsoever. Yes, it is horrible that we use animals to feed ourselves and the products of animals to feed ourselves. I do have a problem though. Not a problem with not eating those animals. I mean, granted, being a vegan is fairly expensive in some aspects, sometimes not. You can, I guess, find deals on vegan food, but it doesn't taste the greatest, but you have to be very creative to make it taste better. I mean, I'm partially vegan. I eat some vegan foods. I still do eat certain meats and whatever, but yeah, I'm not fully there yet, but I'm working on it. I'm just not as angry and aggressive about it as everyone else is. Yes, it's still a moral issue that we need to work on as far as the animals that we use for food and how we treat them. Once again, I do have a problem though. And my problem is what do we do with the animals if we no longer use them as foodstuffs? Where do we send them? Who's going to take care of them? They are domesticated animals. They are used to us taking care of them. Yes, it's our fault that they are this way, but what do we do with these animals now that we are no longer going to be using them for food? Do we send them out to pasture? Well, just for the cattle around the world, I mean, we have almost a billion cattle on this planet. What do we do with them? We have enough cattle to fill an entire state like the size of Texas. Do we give them a state the size of Texas or an area the size of Texas and let them roam free? Now, mind you, that's just the cattle. When we're talking about the chickens and geese or whatever, ducks or whatever else anyone's eating, what do we do with them? Do we just let them roam free? Well, the problem with that is they'll, of course, breed. And they'll start to grow more so in numbers because their numbers won't be controlled because, you know, there's no predators for livestock. We're not going to import predators to take care of the livestock that we're no longer eating. What do we do with them? How do we control the numbers? Do we have hunting seasons for them? Do we just let them roam free since we're not going to be eating them anymore? Do we have that much land to be able to take care of them? Who are we going to pay to take care of them? Let's not forget that they are used to getting medical treatment. So who's going to give them antibiotics, which is bad anyway, but who's going to treat them? Who's going to offer them veterinary services? How will they be taken care of? Once again, I agree that no, we should not be using animals to feed ourselves because it is extremely cruel how they are treated when they are being processed for us to enjoy a hamburger or a sandwich. I agree, it's horrible. I've seen it and it's bad. But we still have to take care of these animals. Yes, it's our fault that we've raised them for the past 10,000 plus years to be our livestock. And now we should be responsible for taking care of them, let's say today, if no one ever ate another cow. Who's going to take care of them? Who's going to pay to take care of them? Do we start a world fund to take care of the animals that we're no longer eating? How do we do it? Do we tax everyone for it worldwide? Do we tax local municipalities? Do certain states have to take so many cattle and take care of them until they die? What about diseases? When they get sick, they'll spread diseases, which can affect our regular food. Let's not forget that, most of them are, well, all cattle are herbivores. So they'll start to compete for the vegan, green, leafy food that we eat. Because can you pin them up? Who's going to put up a fence line big enough to hold 1 billion cattle? Remember, that's just the cattle. Who's going to do all the work to take care of them? I'm not volunteering. I mean, I'm really not good with livestock. I mean, I'm good with people, I fix those, but livestock, that's not my thing. But what do we do with these people? Seriously, I'm at a loss at this. I agree on one hand that yes, we should not be doing this to them. It's cruel. But is it even more cruel and more immoral to now set domesticated livestock animals free for them to die horribly from diseases, possibly famine, overcrowding? What do we do to them? They won't have enough room. We can't just take a state and say, hey, here's a state for all the cattle. What do we do? Because I think it's even more cruel, just my opinion, of course, it's more cruel to let them go and send them off somewhere. I mean, they're not like people where they can be autonomous more or less and do their own thing, think for themselves, build homes, start their own communities and whatnot. That's not different because I know some people will bring up the slavery thing. I get it. But that still doesn't kind of work with animals because they can't drive cars and buy stuff from the store and, pay taxes. So we have to think of what it is that we would be able to do for them. Now that we've decided to let them go, where do we send them? Who's going to take care of them? So, if anyone has an idea of how to fix that particular problem with just the cattle worldwide, please feel free. Leave a comment down below. I will be happy to engage with anyone, especially if you're vegan, on how we can resolve that issue. I'm more than happy to listen because I have no idea. And to Cosmic Skeptic, which he probably will never see this video, but I really would like for him to sit back and think of, yes, once again, I agree with everything he said about veganism and about the treatment of livestock animals. I agree with that, no argument at all. But he still needs to address, what are we going to do with the animals? Because this shoulder shrug thing isn't a good idea. That doesn't work. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure to hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the bell down below, right about here, so that you can be notified when I post new content. Have a nice evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please be safe. Don't forget to vote. Please don't forget to vote, because if you don't vote, you really can't complain about what's going on. But vote. That is our life's blood, and that's what's hopefully going to save us from the plight that we're in now. Have a great evening. Please enjoy the rest of your weekend. Be safe out there. And don't forget, by all means, please be the best heathens that you can be. And good night. Thank you.